The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another exciting edition of the Power Trading Hour with me, your humble, lovable, and squeezably soft host.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
And what do we have going on today? Well, just more of a kind of a shake, rattle, and roll. If we had a musical theme for the day, down about 9 points on the S&P cash, Dow's off 109, NASDAQ's up 25, Russell's down half a point, crude's off 20 cents, XLE a lot worse. I will take a look at that. Volume as we start the show is just hitting about 4 billion shares. On Friday, I said that the odds of testing the high or the low had gone to about 50%, and in the words of Homie the Clown, Homie, don't play that game. It just felt more like a coin flip. We're down a little bit today on the S&Ps. Again, I was in individual stocks, but I would have gotten stopped out today if I wouldn't have gone ahead and taken the money on Friday on most everything. So I'm kind of happy with that. But we're in one of those periods where a lot of people, I think, are looking at it as either half full or half empty. I'm figuring that maybe that's just where it's going to be full too. There's always the thought that you can go sideways. And as far as I can tell, looking at a lot of charts over the weekend, it's lower highs and higher lows. And that's one of the worst markets to be in, because all you do is make less and less, with the risk being the same or even more as it goes higher. You never know when that one piece of news hits the timeline. You get stopped out if you're lucky. If you're not lucky, you got down and you get crushed. I am a big fan right now of being pretty much in all cash and waiting for the next opportunity to come down. Just kind of a nice heater right down the center of the plate. One that you could put right over the center field wall. Maybe we'll get that. Maybe we'll get a double or triple or even a single. But I'm waiting for the next big signal to figure out what's going on. But as far as I can tell from this morning in the volume, nothing has changed to make me think that we're seeing lower highs and higher lows. So a dwindling trading range as we work out whether we're oversold or overbought. But eventually we'll get one. I hate being in these because at least historically when I've gone back and tried to play triangles, invariably the ball kind of bounces the other way. It's not like a basketball, more like a football. The thing can kind of wag around, and most of the times when they do break out, the first break is to the head fake side, and about 80% of the time, I'm more than likely to take whatever the break of a triangle is and fade it on the break if the volume's light. So we'll see what happens this week. Could be just a few more days of this kind of up and down motion. And of course, what, 2 weeks? I say we're 2 weeks from the election for the most part. And we may even have a market that's kind of waiting for that. But kind of tough to say. We'll keep an eye on it. But I don't see a lot of reason to be putting a lot of risk out, either long or short, at this part. Of course, over the weekend, China threw a bunch of cash at the problem. They saw their markets bounce, but again, they're way off the highs. I don't know if you can really, believe a lot or read a lot into it other than the fact that probably a lot of people were short and got reversed over the weekend. Of course, that is putting a little pressure on the dollar, because it's basically what they did was a devaluation of their currency by pushing more cash out and not actually just going straight at the currency. 95.72 is the last quote we have on the dollar index. When we look at the at gold and some of the other things, off $3, it's 12.2570. And as long as this thing doesn't go below $1,200, you should be okay in gold. Below $1,200 probably is one of the biggest major failures. So I'm not predicting that. I'm just saying that if it does dip below $1,200 one more time and close below that level, you're probably could be looking at much lower. So as long as it stays here, probably 80% chance. You've got a good trade starting off here. The downside would be a close below 1200 and some major destruction to the price on that. Copper, $2.78. And that's probably about it as we look at the numbers. Just not that much happening overall other than the S&P. It continues to be a rolling auction. Every time in the morning, it looks like we've got some buyers. By the afternoon, we've got some sellers. It wasn't really that bad at the close on Friday, but we should not have at all given up that 2,800 level on Friday. So that tells you that we've got the lower high in place, and now we're looking maybe for a lower low or not a lower low. But as long as I'm cash, they can trash the market all they like. I'll be more than glad to pick up the low side of this market. Got a little bit of history, and then we'll go on to some charts.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 1962, televised speech, John F. Kennedy announces U.S. spy planes have discovered Soviet missile bases in Cuba. These missile sites under construction but nearing completion house medium-range nuclear missiles capable of striking a number of major cities in the United States, including Washington, D.C. Probably one of the unknown tales of this day that is forgotten a great deal is a missile commander on a submarine. Two of the three people on the submarine had voted to launch a nuclear tip torpedo at an aircraft carrier of ours that was blockading Cuba. Vasily Arkhipov, probably the way it's pronounced or close to it. Anyway, Vasily was the lone holdout where in the United States you have to have two people actually give their keys up to launch a missile. In Russia, you needed three. They had one political officer and two actually regular officers. Vasily got his post because of the K-129 when the thing was melting down and his bravery there just a year before. But if there is one man that saved us on this day, it was Vasily. Arkhipov? Well, we'll know. See you on the opposite side.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN has launched our brand new website.
You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Yep, a little bit of rock and roll, a little bit of country, and a little bit of everything for everyone. But yeah, just kind of hanging out in this mid-range, and we may do that for a few days. Got a lot of earnings starting to come on. Earnings have been okay. They haven't been blowout, and they haven't been blown down as bad as previous earnings. But at the same time, there's kind of a little bit of... melancholy. I'm going to probably best way to say that way earnings are being approached is a little bit of melancholy. And we may take all the way through the elections to get that out. But everybody's kind of just looking out there waiting for the sky to fall. And it's going to be kind of tough, I think, to see meaningful gains until we get a few of these things off our backs. But never know. Anyway, going to be looking at a variety of stocks out here. I had a question on a couple of the stocks in defense, especially with potentially issues with Saudi contracts. General Dynamics actually back into some support area around 190. That's the August 13th low, 190.48. Got to 189 today. So far, the volume's about half of that August 13th low. Boeing looks like they're getting a huge contract from Germany. Not doing much with that today. It's down on fairly light volume. Testing its October 12th low at 352.26 with about 1.4 million shares so far. So it looks like we've got some kind of shelf of support. I don't know, $5 billion? Just people to sneeze at that these days. LMT, take a quick look at it. It's down 0.6% today. Did open up a little higher. 329 has been kind of a level of support and resistance. And kind of going through that today. Anyway, you got What we got here? We got kind of a nice level of support in this one too. Volume's a little bit more than the rest. I don't know if you can make a great deal out of this one. NOC, Northrop, down 0.5% today. But again, a lot of these, especially this one, you did kind of slightly break the low out here on October 12th compared to the September 20th on Northrop, NOC. But a lot of these things are just in wider trading ranges, and I'm not going to make too much about them until you get yet a bigger signal. You can give me a call at 877-927-6648. You can email me at path@tfnn.com. And, of course, you can always put a message in the den. Let me see about some other things out here. I wanted to look. Take a quick look at Facebook. See what they're doing today. I haven't looked at them yet. This thing's just kind of hovering around here. No clear signal other than it's going sideways for, what, the last 2 or 3 days. Don't see a lot in here. You probably would like to see a retest of 149.16. I still suspect it will be under pressure for some time to come. See if there was anything else going on here before we get into the rest of them. Okay. Got some requests to take a quick look at AMD. They had a huge upgrade. Basically, if you read the upgrade, basically they could turn lead into gold. I haven't seen such a positive spin on a company in a long time. Certainly after the huge move down on Friday, got to 2360 on Friday with 130 million shares. We're up today, actually on some decent volume, but gave a great deal of that pop back. About 95 million shares today. Let's take a quick look at Intel. Okay. Yeah, it's up a little bit. Volume's not happened much. Friday, the news started rolling out that Intel's deal with Micron also looked like it was hitting the skids and having a bit of problems. You came down volume slightly increased on Friday. You needed to retest this October 11th high volume low at 43.73. That had 44 million shares. You came into it 28 million shares. So you're getting a little bit of a bounce. Micron and Intel developed the what's going to be the long-term new memory over the coming years. They had a deal to continue to work on that memory. For some reason, unreally clear on Friday, Micron and Intel are splitting and going their own ways on the new, what is called cross-point memory. Certainly, 1,000 times faster, 10 times less power, and non-volatile. Literally everything you want. Very unclear about what the whole thing was. Now, Micron did go through this high volume low at $40.68 today. It's trying to close back in there right at 40 bucks. But again, a lot of people are talking about kind of a soft spot in video card business, and a huge amount of money that Micron makes is for those video cards. Now, AMD bounced a little bit on their upgrade, but the question is whether NVIDIA did much of anything, and the answer is no. They also blew through the July 2nd, 233.26, July 2nd low that had 9 million shares and did that on Friday with 15 million shares. So that started to be some of the problem. The next level of support for NVIDIA comes in at this gap. That gap comes in at $220. So I'm not expecting to see a lot out of the SMHs until these things, both AMD and NVIDIA, find some kind of lows. Now, if we look at the semiconductors, they bounced. We've pulled back down here, and we do have fairly light volume in at least the SMHs. October 11th, 21 million shares at $94.67. We had just 9.4 million shares on Friday. Today, just 4.5 million shares. So the SMHs could be making a temporary low out here. But again, until some of the other bigger stocks on the market actually make some better signal, it looks like it may be problematic. Okay, what else? Yeah, confusing the reasons. Okay. Oh, we'll be back in a minute. We'll look at Tesla, look at a handful of others, and got a lot of stuff to look at here today. We might be seeing something set up by Wednesday. We'll take a look.
The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked, money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of tfnn.com.
And we are back. Anyway, we're looking at the SMH. Guess we should look at the stocks real quick, too, as long as we're going down this path. Certainly back into some support area. You do have a thrust that goes down to 162.18 in the stocks with 2 million shares. So, you know, you had 1.4 million shares on Friday. Today, about 700,000. So there's not a lot of volume. But at the same time, we'd love to see one of these things pierce and get a clear signal. But so far, still, at least in the short term, lower or higher lows and lower highs. Would have liked to seen the SOX actually come back up to this first level of resistance, which was about 177. We didn't get there. We got to just over a hair off 175. So again, we're going to need to build some cause to go higher, and maybe that takes another couple of days. We're going to talk about Tesla. As we said a couple weeks ago, or was it a week ago? A week ago, they no longer get their $7,500 tax credits if you buy a Tesla. It's slowly been moving down to lower lows. The hysteria from a handful of people on Wall Street has gotten to, I think, fairly all-time highs. This thing is worth $4,000 a share over the next 10 years. I think I heard that on Friday by one knob, K-N-O-B, on Financial Infotainment TV. I don't know how you could actually say that, especially with all the other car companies. And they're all going to be fighting for business. They're all going to have their $7,500 tax credit that Tesla won't have. So pretty much a huge competitive disadvantage, at least in the United States. The rest of Europe, including the Scandinavian countries, have gotten rid of their tax credits. And probably the biggest one has been Germany. So you're going to pay for whatever the car costs now. There's no government subsidies on it. And of course, that's problematic. But again, you always have a 30% short interest in Tesla. And any day you could watch this thing go up 20 or 30 bucks and just a small short squeeze. Okay, what else do we have? Wanted to look at a few things. Wanted to look at Yelp. It's come off the highs after I had a fairly decent sell signal at the high. This tested the August 10th high. That was $51.33 with 9.3 million shares. With 5 million shares, it went, about $1.20 over that high on September 20th. With 5 million shares reversed next few days. It's come back down to this level of support where this gapped up on huge volume of 26.3 million shares, got into it with just 3.8 million shares. So if this could get back to 40 and it had a light volume the next few days, that would be probably one of the better looking chart formations. I just don't know if this sector like Snap or Facebook or the rest of the socials actually seems to have anybody interested in buying it at all. TSEM, which is a Tower Semiconductor. Going to look at a few more of these. About the same volume at the previous low of $19.26. That was on August 17th. Saw a little bit more volume on Friday, 370,000 shares. But light volume today. But again, a lot of the stuff just looks like bigger trading ranges in that. I haven't looked at TrueCar for a while. See what this one's doing. Now, you had a nice gap up with a thrust and lots of volume on August 10th. You did so with 7 million shares. Came into it with 1 million shares on August 29th. Friday, you had 583,000 shares. Today, a complete filling of this gap. So far, 200,000 shares. I just don't know whether or not, again, these online companies have a lot to say about people coming in and buying them. Charts don't look all that bad, but man, it doesn't look like anybody's willing to step in and catch the javelin. Trimble Navigation, another one out here that's coming back into its huge gap up and sign of strength. On this one, it was August 2nd, 3.4 million shares. We're down into it with 279,000 shares. This is one of the reasons why I can't really be very bearish on the market right now. A lot of these stocks continue to come down on light volume, a handful of them on heavy volume, but for the most part, a lot of them on lighter volume. And actually, if we can find some kind of low, they're going to look fairly good. Let's see if there's anything else out here. Tapestry. This one's a fairly new IPO of what, a year ago? That long ago? Let's go ahead and pull up the profile. Again, you can give me a call at 877-927-6648 or email me at path@tfnn.com. Tapestry provides luxury accessories and lifestyle brands in the United States and China. I was looking for the names. I think they've got some brand names that are famous. Kate Spade, Coach, Weisman operated stores. I guess they sell a lot of stuff. It's been around since 1941. Probably the worst year to open up a business, the start of a major war, but I guess they did. Internet, I guess they got a lot of stuff. $43.20 was the May 29th low with just under 7 million shares. You tested that with 2.7 million shares on Friday. You're just kind of out here with a little bit of juice out here today. Tilray, believe it or not, this thing actually making a signal back to the September 29th low, $79.12. Got to 115.50 so far today, but it certainly looks like those $97 lows of September 24th looks like where that thing is headed over the next few days. Very, very rare that you see a company go to from 100 or 50 to 300 bucks. And not see that the entire company eventually gets blown up by it. Let's see what else we have out here. We have enough time to get a couple of them. Triumph Bank Corp, TBX, TBK, TBK. Looks like this one's going to close below the October 12th low that had 279. You got 222,000 already. Small regional bank. Synaptics. Back into some previous lows, actually with fairly light volume, could make it back down to 35. SYN, let's see what else we have. SXT, this one got blown apart the last couple of days. I don't know if we need to get too far into that. We said we were going to look at the XLE, see if I can get that before the break. It doesn't look like it. We'll talk more about this, but certainly breaking through the previous August 15th low today. We'll talk about that when we return.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The TAS Profile Scanner Plus, developed by John Logan and his team, is a standalone piece of software that can change the way you trade. Let the TAS Profile Scanner work for you by scanning over 5,000 financial instruments such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. Right now, you can get a 30-day free trial to the TAS Profile Scanner Plus right at TFNN.com. And when you sign up, you gain instant access to John Logan's most recent webinar, How Price, Volume, and Time Make Market Profiles So Unique. This hour-long webinar with John Logan will walk you through the most powerful features of the scanner and how you can use it to become a more successful and profitable trader. You pay absolutely nothing for 30 days while you try out this software risk-free. For more information on the TAS Profile Scanner and to get your 30-day free trial today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we're back. Okay. Oh, we were talking about XLE. And you did break through the August 15th, $71.70 low that had 26 million shares with a little less than 8 million shares so far today. Does look like we've broken through that level, though. So the next level set up here is at about $68. What else? I think that's about it. Let's see what else is on my list of stuff. Stamps.com. I wondered whether or not the changes in the regulation for shipping things from China and other countries would affect these guys. They've come at least back into what should be fairly decent support levels. This goes back to February 22nd, 1.4 million shares when this thing gapped up. And you had 317,000 shares. So again, a lot of these stocks don't look that bad. They just don't have any sign that people are buying them. And some of them continue to drift lower. To STAY, take a quick look at that one. Extended Stay America. This is a lot of hotels down here in Florida are like that, are like this. And that is that you can go in there and rent them for for 30 days. But a lot of them down here in Florida, people want to come down for more than a handful of days. And I guess they're not the nicest of places, but they're not the worst of places either. Back into this February 6th low, $17.58, 1.9 million shares with 600,000 shares. Probably a better place to look at this thing, though, would be at $17 when this gapped up with 3 million shares. Back in 2017 on December 23rd, you've got a fairly nice high level and probably a trading range from about $23 to $17. Question: why did the leaders of Tillman Air Force Base leave the F-22s to get destroyed by a hurricane? I don't think they've been destroyed. I think that story was, from what I read over the weekend, had some fairly minor damage. So, I think a lot of people just like to. I don't know if it's fake news, but at the same time, from what I heard, that there wasn't that much done to them. So, just highly exaggerated. At least that's what I've heard so far. Or maybe it's a cover story. They wanted to say they got hit so they could go and make some changes to them. There's been a lot of talk about taking the F-35 avionics and putting it in the F-22s. That may just be, I'm always, anytime it comes to the military, I'm always half sure that any news that comes out of it is a cover story for them to do something else. So, tends to that. But yeah, from, I think I saw something up there about how the damage wasn't that bad. They were all going to take them off and do something. But certainly the preeminent fighter of all time, actually probably would have been better off with nothing but those F-22s than the F-35s. But, you live, you learn. Splunk has splunked down into some fairly decent support areas from June 28th and July 30th. Both of those had about 3 million shares. Got into it with 3.2 million shares on Friday. Today got a little bit of a hammer out here, and that is 2.6 million shares already, but it is holding that area. Energy is about the same on the way up as on the way down. Let's see. SMG, which is Scott's Miracle-Gro. This is the company that if I wanted to be in the marijuana business, I'd be in. It, like the rest of everything, is going down. So maybe there's a better buy out here longer term. I think these guys really ran at the very beginning of it. Now you're back into some fairly massive support. This gapped up on, August 3rd of 2016. So you're back all the way to that level off after being up at $109.06. So what, you're down about, 40%? I'm going to call it about 40%. Back to what should be fairly decent support from about $70 to about $73. So we'll take a look at it. That and Cree are my big picks in the marijuana business, long-term, not short-term. Even gold, when it took off in 2000, had a fairly decent pullback after the initial run. Cree had a nice little run off of earnings and a lot of volume back on the 16th. Pretty sure that had earnings on the 16th. Now you're pulling back here with lighter volume, but if I'm sure about one thing, it's going to be that the taxes will be very high on marijuana. People will start actually growing it themselves, and grow lights and fertilizer and seeds will probably be the big business going forward. Fairly light volume out here. Cree at about $33.72, that October 11th low. You probably want to be, you know, if you're really thinking about being in that business, it's one, legal. It's two, you can account for it. And three, you know what? People are buying lights for other things other than just growing marijuana. So I like Scott's and I like Cree at the right price. I haven't found it yet. Let's take a look at some other ones out here. Shop, Mr. Shopify. Finding some fairly decent support in this 125 area. As we look at the low on the 11th of October, you had 2 million shares. Got into it Friday with 2.2 million shares, up today on 2 million shares. Not the best chart pattern of all time, but for internet stocks, it doesn't look all that bad. Shake Shack, or as I affectionately call it, Soylent Green, is coming back to this huge gap up that goes back to May 4th. That was 6.8 million shares. You spiked into it on Friday with 900,000 shares. Today you got 276. So as I say, I'm not real bearish on the market. I just think that we could get a little bit more of a buyer strike and find this one. I would love to see this one at about $50-$51 for a possible buy. We'll be man, I'm feeling a little bit like Porky Pig. We'll be back.
Jason Path has just launched his weekly newsletter, The Quantitative Edge, available only at TFNN.com. Right now, you can sign up for Jason's outstanding weekly report, including midweek updates whenever warranted, with a 30-day money-back guarantee included, so you have nothing to risk. Jason develops his trade recommendations by creating an ensemble of predictive and mathematical models trained on data by leveraging a variety of techniques, including market-based computer simulations. Jason then combines these sophisticated predictive and analytical models with deeply researched macro outlooks to identify opportunities in a number of different markets for traders to act on. Whether you're looking to trade futures, equities, commodities like crude oil and gold, Forex, or cryptos, Jason covers it all. Sign up for Jason Path's weekly trading newsletter right now by visiting the front page of TFNN.com, and you'll find the Quantitative Edge under the Newsletters tab. TFNN.com, educating investors.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
I'm certain you are, or strive to be, one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools, as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And we're off 8 on the S&P. Dow's off 56. NASDAQ's up 26. The Russell's off 5. And crude oil's off 20. I've never been a big fan of Roku. It looked to me like they're throwing a lot of money to make sure that they're in a lot of TVs, which is probably not a bad idea. I just don't know if it's... I almost hear nobody talking to me about signing up for Roku. That could just be anecdotal. Maybe other people have. But I guess the big deal is that packages are expensive. The only thing more expensive is a few things on Roku, at least from what I hear. But you know what? On the chart basis, you've got August 9th. This gapped up with almost 40 million shares. On Friday, we're back into it with 8.8 million shares. Today, about 5 million shares in a little doji. About $50 on it would be something you'd have to take a look at just based on the chart pattern. Let's see if there's anything else in my list of stuff out here that I wanted to look at. To a bunch of stuff. Let's see if we can't get one more little gem out here. KBH. That'll probably tell us a lot about what's going on. KBH Homes just continue to melt. Your next long-term low is at $13.88. That takes you all the way back to November 2nd of 2016, you really just don't have a, you know, you kind of got something at about $17, which is kind of like the right shoulder of this low off November 2nd in 2016. So that'd be about it. But I don't see any real changes coming until certainly the next Fed meeting. So I don't think much is going to change in that way. 38.72, just a scant few months ago on February 11th. In the meantime, sell when you can, not when you have to. We will be back tomorrow, same time, same channel.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.